Good morning, you guys. Welcome to another chapter. So today is the day. So today is a gender reveal video. It's just going to be included in this vlog. I'm excited. I'm just going to take you guys along for the journey. And when my husband comes home later, we're going to pop the little confetti, I think is what they call it. And yeah, we're going to go from there. I'm here warming up myself some breakfast because I've been up for 50 minutes and I don't feel so good. So today's one of those days. Some days are easier than some where I'm okay, and other days I just don't feel well. So I have to eat and take my meds, and sometimes taking my meds once for the day will make me okay. But then sometimes I have to take it twice or three times before I'm like really okay. These kitties are over here play fighting. Yeah, but I'm excited. We're gonna find the baby's gender. It kind of sucks because my husband won't be home till like 8. Oh, so we still have a long way to wait, but at least we know it's today for sure. That's the only part of the vlog I'll really be waiting for. And then, I'll explain more. Get off my feet. I'm gonna get some breakfast. Got some plantains in here. I'll tell you guys how much I love the plantains of late. It's so good. To school, I want to vomit literally as I get into this car. I'm telling you, so hard being pregnant. Oh god, come on, it's not easy being pregnant at all. My tummy is just very upset today. Yeah, I'm gonna vomit. Okay,
did you try to love me? Oh, you're so cute, so cute, so cute. Your family's gonna love you when they get you. You're a darling. Look at the tummy. You look a foot trying to bite me up. Trying to bite me up. Hands up. All fives. All five paws up.
You're such a sweetheart. These kitties are so sweet.
I got work to do, okay, Bubby? I gotta prepare the house for the gender reveal. So I gotta do a little shopping for some balloons. Yes, some balloons. I'm going to Party City. You coming? You won't come. You won't come.
You're not coming. You gotta stay with the milk. They got sharp little teeth, huh? Jeez.
I'm gonna go pick up baby cakes from school and head to my appointment now.
I haven't done much vlogging at all today. When I come back, we'll finish the house. I just want to make sure the cat and kitten area is cleaned up. So, like, they're all sleeping. They sleep in here so well when it's nice and clean.
I really disinfect and put new bed in. They're all just sleeping.
Little Caitlin got her teacher's gave her for last time when she was having such a bad day. Look at that. I love your flower.
I got it from the prize because I was cleaning up.
Good job.
I'm so excited.
You excited? We are in Bloomingville. I'm stopping at this Walmart.
What is Bloomingville?
It's another city further east. What? We are stopping. We're just like 2 minutes from the place. We're just stopping at McDonald's to get something to
drink. Are we in a different country?
No, city. You got your stuff? Okay, awesome. I got me a iced coffee, vanilla, because I'm trying to wake up this baby. I want it as active as possible. No sleeping. Should've brought a piece of my pudding I baked. Or her.
I already know, Mom.
Aw, you don't know yet. She wants a girl. Is he barred in with a baby gate? Is that why he's going crazy?
No, he's out there in the open. He just has separation anxiety. And he knows that, like, people are here.
Yeah.
That's another reason why I always do, like, the doggy daycare. That way he can be, like, with somebody.
Mm-hmm.
He just doesn't like to be alone.
Oh, look. Look, mama. All curled up in there.
What do you think? What does it look like?
Mm-hmm. See his little face over there. Little foot bottom. Oh, the hands.
We're all done. I got it, you guys.
I'm really excited. I'm excited. I can't wait for later. Oh my gosh. Huh? Whew. All right. So me and Baby Cake is at the park.
No, but you can still watch
me. Okay. Aren't you gonna help me slide with me? We're at the park for a little. We're just burning some time. We have so much time. Come on. No, you're down here. That's yours. Ready? Set. Oh, my bum. Good job, Felix. Buddy, can his bum poop in peace without you being right there? Hi, Smudge. Are you going to try to poopy too? Get out of his doo-doo. Look at you. Have some respect. Good job. You got to go a little bit closer, though, to cover it. You're doing so good, though.
What do you think?
They're outside for the first time.
What do you think, guys? It's grass.
Mm-hmm. You know, funny surroundings, huh? I don't think they like the feel of the grass.
What do you think? Bella. Where's Bella? Bella.
So at the appointment, this is the little box that they give you. It's a keepsake box. It came with the package that I chose. Beautiful, beautiful place. The busy. Oh my god, beautiful, breathtakingly beautiful. So this is the box. This is what's in there. Your ultrasound pictures, both 3D and 2D. No, both, I think it's HD live or something like that. Over here is my little USB of the entire session. Such a fancy little USB too. It's amazing. Aww. Look at this. Aww, she's crazy with me. Look. Aww. Look like he's just sleeping. He had his hands over there. How beautiful. Wow. Oh, little bum bum. Then look. Aww. Look at his perfect little head and spine and legs and everything. That is gorgeous. And then you have, like, you know, your regular pictures of baby here. Oh, a little profile. So, so cute. Yes, Luna. Luna, no. And then what it comes with is this, the package, this little confetti thing. And inside is the gender. I don't know what it is just yet. When she was doing it, I tried my best to not look. But there were points where I just decided to see if I could even tell, and there was a time where I thought, like, for sure, like, oh whoa, that, I think it's a girl. But then when she started doing other things, I thought I saw, like, a little penis. So I'm like, oh, I don't know now. I really don't know what it is. I don't know if it's a boy, and I don't know if it's a girl, because I feel like I saw some part of something that looked like both, but I don't know. So only time will tell. But I'm so excited. And then later we'll watch this DVD, because when she did find out a gender, it's also on here, so I don't want to go looking. So later, after my husband finished working, we find out the gender, then we're gonna come home and watch this on the big screen TV. So I'm so, so excited. Like, so excited.
Oh, hi, big boy. I saw the baby today. I don't know what it is yet.
Is it out?
No, not yet. I don't know what it is yet, though. We're gonna pop this special thing at the park later. Yeah, it's gonna twist and it's gonna come out either blue or pink.
White.
Yeah.
Or brown.
I don't mean the baby's color. It's gonna tell us if it's a boy or a little girl. How was school today?
Good.
That's good. Whew.
It is a nice day out. Oh my gosh. So sunny.
So I saw the baby today.
Is it a boy?
I don't know yet. We're gonna find out later at the park when. Stop fighting!
Guys, I know. So this is what it looks like, Bexy. So,
oh yeah, I remember you. You gotta pop it up.
What is that?
Oh yeah, no. Okay, stop.
What is that?
It's don't touch it, okay?
It's a popper.
It's for the popper.
One.
Ready?
Yeah.
Jared,
you think him look like you?
It's a girl.
It's not a boy.
We don't know what it is.
It's a girl.
Do you know what you're looking at?
No.
Look.
Oh, that's the baby.
My dad. But
what does he look like?
Do you know what the head is?
The head is.
Yeah, that's right. Do you see a nosy?
No.
No.
It's Kara, put him
is
down.
Is the nosy right there?
No.
Oh my god.
And this is him booty. You see him tiny with the butt cheeks? And then this is him foot. He's trying to kick. This is his back. See his little butt right there. I think you're more excited about this than anybody else, Baba. So just before I head out, because we're going to do this at a park, I wanted to do some of the old wife tales, gender predictions that you see online. So we'll start with the skin changes. They say if you don't break out in acne, then, or your skin don't break out, then you're carrying a boy. And if you break out, it's a girl. It's clearing up now, but remember I told you guys how I was breaking out really bad. It was like so, so bad. But that's weird because when I was pregnant with Max, I had severe breakouts. So I don't know. I felt like Max stole all my beauties while my girls, I don't really remember that happening. But I remember I was glowing a lot with my pregnancies with my girls. So this one's like a little bit of half and half, but if I'm going to really give it to it, I guess we'll say we'll give that point to girl. So the next one is baby's heart rate. They say if baby's heart rate is below 140, then it's a boy. And if it's above that, then it's a girl. When I went today, it was 155 beats. So I guess that's another point for girl. The next one is dreams. They said if you're having a lot of vivid dreams, like intense stuff, motorcycles, like just a lot of crazy stuff, okay? Like jumping out of a plane, all that stuff, that means boy. And if you're having more of the calmer dreams, like, you know, you're dreaming about makeup, mother nature, all that stuff, then it's a girl. I've been having a lot of vivid, crazy dreams. Like, I mean, some intense stuff, okay? Like, some I don't even know. Just some crazy dreams. So that's one point for boy. The next one is, are you gaining weight or are you not really gaining too much weight? I feel like I've been gaining weight throughout the pregnancy. Like, there's not a time that I'm not gaining weight. So I feel like that point, they say if you're gaining weight, that means boy. And if you're not gaining weight, that means girl. And I feel like with this pregnancy, I've definitely been putting on the weight. So I'm going to go point for boy. And then the next thing is, what is it? I totally forgot what it is. Oh my god, hold on. So the next thing is cravings. They say if you're craving things like chips, like anything like salty or sour, that usually indicates a boy, and anything sweet usually indicates a girl. I'm sure you guys already know the answer to that one because the whole pregnancy I told you guys I cannot do sweets. I can't. It has to be salty or sour. Anything sweet, I want to throw up. So that is a one point for boy again. Next one is the gender of your kids that you have now. So they say if your girl child shows interest in your belly or in you, then it's the opposite sex. But if your boy child shows interest, the funny thing is Kate is constantly a clingy child. So she shows a lot more interest. Like, she's always with me, I should say. Whereas Max, I feel like Max, I feel like Max has been really indulged into this pregnancy, like in terms of to rub my belly at random times or to ask about the baby. You know, he seems just a lot more loving lately. So I don't know. For me, I feel like on my side it's 50-50. I don't know. I think I might just go for girl for this one just because of just how Max and Craig have been a lot more closey-closey to me. So, yeah. The next one is morning sickness. They say if you have severely bad morning sickness, it's a girl. And if it's pretty okay and moderate or next to none, it's a boy. You guys know, I've told you guys the morning sickness has been like the death of me this whole pregnancy. So I guess that's another point for girl. I did throw up a lot when I was pregnant with Kiki. But I feel like I did the same with Max, but I don't know. We'll see. But I guess the point goes to girl again. The next one is the Chinese gender chart. So I was 26 when I conceived, and that was in March. So according to that, I'm having a little boy. Usually it's right. I think it was wrong for one of my kids. I don't remember which one. So I guess we'll see. That's 1 point for boy. So the next one is the ring test. It says that if you are having a boy, it should swing side to side. And if it swings in a circular motion, it means that you're having a girl. So let's see. We want this to be fair as possible. So. Okay,
trying to balance it out so it's fair. Okay. Oh.
Oh. Wait, I don't know. I feel like it's doing both, but it's swinging back and forth. Oh, this is confusing. This is confusing. I feel like it's doing both, but I feel like it's more swinging. I feel like it's more swinging. Okay. I feel like it's more swinging, so it's point for boy.
The last one is the urine test. So I have a cup of urine here and some baking soda, and it says if it fizzes, then you're having a boy, and if it does nothing, then it's a girl. So let's see what happens. Wait. Absolutely nothing happened. Look at that. Nothing happened. Tiny bit of fizz, but tiny, tiny bit of fizz. I think it's just because it's more breaking it down.
But what is in there?
Nothing, babe.
What is in the cup?
Oh, I see fizz. But didn't fizz right away, so I feel like that point was more for the girl.
But what's in here?
Stuff. Alright, so I'm all ready. I am team neutral. I'm everybody. So, yeah. So we're getting ready to leave out now so you can see the girls, the boys. You can tell who's on whose team. Yep, that's right. So I'm just packing some stuff to go. We're gonna come head out of here. It's already 6:12. Like, the time just moves so fast when you at least expect it to. And then you find yourself literally running. I'm gonna meet up with my husband at his workplace, and he's going to change his clothes and stuff. He is team neutral because he didn't want to pick a side, so I just did a white shirt with dark jeans, and I'm just wearing everybody's color, as you can see. I'm tired, so I will see you guys when we are there. I'm so excited. Oh my gosh, I'm really excited. So I'm gonna pack the confetti and everything with me. And I gotta pack my camera. Oh, my tripod. Can't forget the tripod.
I'm excited! The more I get closer and the time, anxiety, man, is killing me.
Alright, we are here. You excited?
Yeah.
Viv's almost here. I had to drop his stuff at work so he can shower.
Kate?
Are you ready?
It's a girl first.
Of course that's Babe. His music's always the loudest thing.
Got it!
I don't know.
Tell me when to press.
Okay. Direct upwards and
guys,
twist.
No, no.
Countdown in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.